any Max, hottest record in the world.
And now it's time for tonight. My screen, my computer screen is just like blah, 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 texts and tweets all about Pierce DeVille. We've been hijacked by Pierce DeVille fans. I've heard Pierce DeVille fans are pretty amazing. I've heard they won awards before. I'm going to ask Pierce DeVille all about their fans and much more when they come into the studio in 3 minutes and 42 seconds time. That is after the first play ever in the world of this track, Circles. It's from their new album, Misadventures, coming on May 13th. This is a real big deal. Pierce DeVille, hottest record. There it is, folks. That is our hottest record in the world today. And delighted to say that I've got the whole of the band, Pierce DeVille, standing right in front of me right now. Hello, guys.
Hey.
Hello, hello.
We're really happy to meet you and to see you over in London. It feels like a really big deal.
Oh, Yeah, well, thank you. It's so nice to be here.
I mean, obviously, you guys can't go, yes, it is a really big deal.
That's the biggest deal, probably, of our generation.
But I always know that it's a big deal when I come to work and there's fans sat outside shivering in the London cold.
Yes, and, we have the best fans.
You have the best fans, right? You got your fans win stuff, right? Didn't they win, like, the award? Didn't you win the award for best fans?
Of course.
Most dedicated fans.
Of course.
So why are Pierce the Veil fans so good? What is it that what is it that makes them stand out?
I feed them treats on the regular.
little fan treats
every time.
Little fan treats.
That's why.
Okay, so that was Circles. That was a world exclusive. It felt very, very hugely anticipated by everyone listening to the show. Does it feel good to get it out there?
It is probably the best feeling of our lives right now to have that out. You know, it's been a long time coming with this record, so we're really excited to have it out.
So 2012 was the last record.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I don't know the distance between your records before then, but was this a long time for you, the kind of four-year gap?
It was, yeah. This was. We took our time on this one, and it's called Misadventures because it was a misadventure. We did all kinds of twists and turns making this record and to make it what it was. We're super excited about it.
And Vic, you went around. You did a bit of gallivanting.
I did a lot of gallivanting.
You're gallivanting.
I love that word. I've never used that word in my life.
It's a great gallivant.
Word. Good on you. That was great.
Thank you.
I don't know what it means. I'm going to go look it up.
Yeah.
I'm completely in shock.
It means kind of wandering about aimlessly, kind of. Obviously, you had a mission.
Yeah, we started off to, we booked our time to make the record, didn't complete it on time. We ended up in the middle of the album doing an entire world tour. We did the Warp Tour in the U.S. and
And the Warp Tour is about 6 months long, isn't it?
It feels like 6 months, yeah. On the sun.
Yes. So we did that and after that, I went on sort of a journey to work on the lyrics. You know, I stayed in all kinds of different cities, different houses, rented different places. I was up in a cabin in the woods at one point. I think I ended the whole process. I took a leap up to Seattle just to write the rest of the album and do some lyric writing. And that's where I finished it with all the Seattle music vibes.
It's great.
There's a lot of vibes in Seattle for music, a lot of legendary stuff.
Yeah. A lot of good vibes. Good vibes. Yeah.
Had you been there before?
Yeah, it's one of my favorite places. That's actually why, my best friend and co-writer back home, Kurt, mm-hmm. Curtis Peoples, he was like, you know, you love Seattle, you love writing there, why don't you just go finish the record there? So I had finished the last few songs up there, and it was a great experience. I've never realized that, you know, to myself, I can do that. I can do these things, you know, like if you want to go write somewhere, just fly there and do it. And it was a really fun experience.
So Misadventures is the album. Can you tell us anything more about the album, or, you know, the fans will be, I mean, I know they've heard a few songs now, but what else is there for
Jaime, tell them all about it.
Come on, Jaime.
Oh, man. Where do we start? I mean, it's so much fun. No, I mean, we definitely, I think with this record, we like Vic was saying, we spent the most time kind of creating it. And I think for us, we went on, like you said, like this crazy journey to kind of like having tours in the middle of it, having like the APMA Awards right in the middle of it. So I think it was just a big stepping stone for us.
Mm. And does it feel like a step, kind of a step forwards as well, like in terms of an evolution of your sound?
Absolutely,
yeah. Honestly, I feel like we're starting like a new life.
Yeah.
Like I feel like a different guy making this record.
A weight has been lifted. Yeah, we're just excited that it's done.
Yeah. Okay. Every record we do too, we try to beat the last one, and that was our goal here, and I think we achieved that.
Mm. I've got a special noise because I know you guys have a bit of you do have an announcement to make, right?
Okay. Yeah. You got a sound?
I've got a sound especially for the announcement. Get ready for this. Hang on. Ooh. Stop this. Hang on.
Oh my God.
Okay, so when this ends, this is when you do your announcement.
Oh my God, okay? This is amazing.
Over to you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen.
Boys and girls.
Come November 25th, we will be doing a headlining tour in the UK.
Woo! Yeah!
That's what I'm talking about.
Yes!
Yeah. So bring your green hat. We're going to have a good time.
Yeah, we'll be hitting UK, Ireland, Europe. We're hitting the whole shebang.
Yeah.
So, November 25th.
How do they get tickets?
Well, you can go to piercetheveil.net, mm-hmm. and you can pick up tickets there. There'll be
all the info.
All the info that you need.
Okay. Get on quick.
So we're super excited. It's been a while since we've toured over here, so it is time.
We get to play Brixton.
Oh, the legendary Brixton, mm-hmm.
Brixton
Academy.
Brixton, we're super excited
for
that.
Super small room.
Super tiny room.
I don't know whether you're joking or not.
No, it's huge. We're really excited for it. It's our first time, actually.
4,500 to 5,000 people.
Yeah, we're hoping more than 10 show up. So.
I think you'll be okay.
All right.
I have a feeling.
Good. She says we'll be all right. We've done it.
Guys, what a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much.
Oh, the pleasure.
You as well.
I know that you did stuff with The Rock Show as well, with Daniel mm-hmm. Carter, which we'll be hearing over the next few weeks on Radio 1, but we're really honored you could come in and see us, so thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
I hope you like my fanfare.
Oh, man. It was delightful.
Gorgeous.
Yes.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
Good. Right. Going to play it again.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's what we do. We play it twice.
Play it all day.
Next level.
So here you go. Your second play of Pierce the Veil Circles. Thank me later, folks.
Love you, Mom.
Thank you so much, guys. You're playing Pierce the Veil twice? Annie, you're the best. Hello, Teen Wolf. Finally, Pierce the Veil. So amazing. I love Pierce the Veil's new song. This is from Rain on My Wings. I was actually crying and screaming at the same time. Guys, that's what you do. You make people cry and scream at the same time.
It's physically impossible.
It's, well... Come on, Jaime.
Sorry.
You're the best.
Thank you, Pierce the Veil.
This is all-time low.
Make sure you download our pre-gig playlist from the BBC iPlayer radio app.
The Radio 1 playlist.
I chose a theme because my dream
dream, if I wasn't playing music, would to be a fighter.
It's the music that gives us energy before we go out on stage.
It's so amazing to see what has been inspiring people in 2016.
Radio 1 playlist.
Make sure you download it from the BBC iPlayer radio app on your smartphone or tablet. Just head to the BBC Playlister and find the playlist from there.